Hello everyone! What's up? I'm Andrew, and today I'd like to do a review. Today I'm going to review Tales from the Loop. Like Dungeons & Dragons, this is an RPG tabletop game. I have been playing it for the past few months with my friends, and I am the game master of our sessions. This is a game that's set in the 80s that never was. It has a lot of the things you'll remember or know about from the 80s, the music, the technology, but it's also got robots, airships, and some weird sci-fi stuff going on. This is basically if Stranger Things or E.T. or The Goonies was an RPG game. In Tales from the Loop, the players will create characters who are kids living in a city near a facility that has one of the world's largest particle accelerators. Just like in lots of 80s movies, some weird sci-fi stuff starts happening, and none of the adults take notice. It's up to the kids to solve the mystery and sometimes save the day. If you're a fan of the 80s, this game will give you lots of really great 80s feels, along with a cool sci-fi vibe. This whole game is based on the art of Simon Stålenhag, who made several paintings of what an alternate sci-fi 80s Sweden would look like. Just like, these paintings along the lines of these, which fill the entire book and make it absolutely beautiful. Tales from the Loop is only the second game that I have ever been the game master for. The first was a free RPG that I found online called Lady Blackbird, and this has been a lot of fun so far. I really like it, and let's talk a little bit about some of the pros and cons of this game. First of all, the rules of play are really easy in this game. Each character has attributes and skills, which each are assigned a different number at the beginning and can be increased with experience points. These numbers tell you how many dice you get to roll when you try to do a certain action. You roll the dice, and for every 6 that you roll, that is considered a success. This game does not have wisdom saving throws or opposed athletic checks, and it's much easier to get into as a game master and as a player than something like Dungeons & Dragons. I find I love the simplicity of gameplay because it allows us to pay a lot more attention to the characters and the setting. Let's talk about the characters. Every player gets to choose their own type of kid. The kid types are all stereotypes, pretty much, from 80s movies, which really helps give it that feel. You've got, like, the popular kid, the rocker, weirdo, bookworm, computer geek, and those help you determine how you're going to play your character. Every character has some base stats, but also they have a problem, a drive, a pride, and relationships with the other characters, all of which tell the GM and the players how they can sort of help this character's story unfold, which is a crucial part of this game. All of the players play as kids, and the rulebook has restricted the age range that you can play from 10 to 15. Actually, in my game, my players were not very comfortable with that, and so we bumped the age range up from 12 to 17. But the rulebook is very specific that you are playing as kids, and some players may not like that as much. For my group, it works pretty well, but sometimes that age restriction can become a little bit awkward. However, some players might like that age range, as you get to play as stupid, silly kids who get to kind of goof off. This game is very focused on solving sci-fi mysteries, and while there is some combat in it, it is much less focused on combat than other RPGs. For some players and GMs, that might be a pro, and for some, that might be a con, and that's something that you would have to consider before you went into this game. This game is well set up to do one-shots or entire campaigns. The GM creates a mystery. Some sort of sci-fi mystery is happening in this town, and the kids are some of the only people who notice it. The kids then have to pursue this mystery, figure out clues, find out what's going on, and hopefully stop whatever the possible bad result is or save the day. This makes story creation a real breeze. It's very easy to come up with just a simple concept and then develop some clues from there, some locations, some NPCs. It's very easy to come up with a one-shot session for Tales from the Loop. However, that structure of the mystery can sometimes be repetitive. If you want to tell a story that's not a standard mystery setup in the way that the rulebook recommends, it is possible. But it is not as easy as your standard mystery. I'm currently working on writing some stories for my players that aren't just standard mysteries, but it is a lot more difficult given that the framework is not there in the rulebook. However, for the most part, I love the mystery style of storytelling. In Tales from the Loop, almost anything can happen, which is so awesome. However, for the most part, it has to have some sort of science fiction premise. A couple of my players are a little bit frustrated that we can't do more supernatural or everyday life sort of things, which we might actually try to do at some point, but again, the framework is not there for that, and it is very sci-fi focused. I think this game is so much fun. I'm really enjoying it. Some crazy and some very silly things have happened in my recent sessions. For example, my players, they all just started a band, And also, they adopted a pet dinosaur. They've met a robot who is questioning his humanity and his existence. And they've also faced down an evil scientist. The world and the storytelling in Tales from the Loop is really amazing. And if you're looking for a new RPG to play, I highly recommend that you give this one a shot. Well, that was my review of Tales from the Loop, you guys. Thank you guys for watching. Leave a comment and subscribe if you like my videos. And I will see you guys in another video very soon. Bye!